Hydraulic hoses. What do you need to make one and how do you do it? Hi everyone, Jim here. And in this video, I'll tell you everything you need to know about the subtle art of making a hydraulic hose. Hoses are the lifeline of all hydraulic systems. But what do you do when your hose is damaged and starts leaking? Well, you can either buy a new one or make one yourself, which is what this video is all about, broken down into 6 easy steps. Before we go ahead, you should realize that a hydraulic system is a system under pressure after all. So you need to make sure you use the correct tools and safety equipment. If you don't have those, don't put yourself and others at risk. Leave it to the experts. If your hose isn't properly assembled, it might lead to leaks or even bursts. All right, let's get started. To make a hydraulic hose, you'll need the following. A hydraulic hose, a tape measure, 2 hydraulic hose fittings, 2 ferrules, a caliper, and a white paint pen. A crimping machine, however, operated by an expert, and hose cleaning equipment. All set? Let's move on to step 1. If you're planning on replacing an old hose, take a good look at this text. This is called the layer line and should give an indication of the hose's technical specs. For example, see where it says 4500 psi? That's the maximum working pressure. DN12 indicates the inner diameter, and this number tells you the norm of the hose. You can use these 2 nifty cheat sheets to find out what each code indicates and which hose and ferrule are right for you. If your hose doesn't show any of this text, you'll have to do your homework. Another more challenging option is to cut the hose, measure the inner diameter, check how many braids are inside and what material they're made of, steel or textile. The same goes for the material of the hose itself. Just like the hose, fittings have specific characteristics such as working pressure, material, attachment method, etc. Make sure the fitting you use matches the hose size and the brand name, because combining materials is not a good idea. By the way, what are you planning to use your hose assembly for? Let me know in a comment section below. Good to know that in some countries it's obligatory to write the maximum working pressure on your hose, as well as the company name and the assembly date. But what do you do if the maximum working pressure of the hose is a different number than the fitting number? Well, you take the lowest number of the 2 and write and mark that on the assembly. All right, let's move on to step number 2. The length from fitting to fitting is called the overall length. The length without the fittings is called the cut hose length. Measure the length of your old hose with a tape measure. And then measure the same length on your new hose. Mark it using a white paint pen. Make sure the cut is straight and perpendicular to the hose and not crooked. Double check to make sure that the cut is right and clean, like this. Afterwards, make sure you clean all dust and residue from your hose to avoid contamination. You can do this by shooting a cleaning projectile through your cut hose, as well as through your assembled hose. All dirt will be removed in the process. To do this, connect your clean launcher to a filtered, regulated air source. Load the recommended nozzle and clean projectile into the launcher's faceplate and close it. The safety release bar will lock it into position. Insert the nozzle into the hose and secure the other end into a container or bucket. Press the trigger until the projectile has exited the opposite end of the hose. You can repeat this process on the other end until the hose is completely clean. Do you see the marking on the fitting? That plastic white ring shows you how deep your hose can go. Place the hose inside the ferrule and then connect the fitting. Make sure they align, and you can use a little bit of the lubricant if you want. Push the hose until the fitting touches the marking. Repeat the process for the other side of the hose. A crimping machine is advanced equipment, so you should leave this step to a professional. Just click here to use Cramp's dealer locator to find an expert near you. An expert will make sure that the ferrule will be crimped to the right dimension, so assembly is according to specifications. If the ferrule is not crimped correctly, the assembly would be vulnerable to leaks or even bursts. The crimped hose should look like this. All right, time to move on to step 5. It's important to clean the hose assembly before mounting it to your hydraulic system and after complete assembly. When you're done cleaning your hose, make sure that you cap the assembly to avoid any dirt or contamination, using either plastic caps with the measurements that match your fitting or heat shrinking caps. To recap, the first step is to find the proper hose and fitting by either checking the layer line or by doing your homework and inspecting and measuring the hose yourself. Next, the hose needs to be cut to its proper length and inserted into the fitting. The next step, crimping the hose, should be left to professionals. Then to make sure you get rid of any contamination, the hose assembly needs to be cleaned with an air gun and cleaning projectile. And finally, a cap needs to be placed on the assembly to make sure it stays nice and clean. And there you have it, how to make a hydraulic hose in 6 easy steps. We have a lot of other videos for you might be interested in. So make sure you hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching and until next time.